What is up, creators? This is Tom. Welcome back to another video. In this one, what I want to talk about is the 2018 MacBook Pro and how it performs for video editing. So, as I said, this is the 2018 MacBook Pro, and it is pretty much the most expensive and fastest computer, or at least a Mac computer, that I think I've ever edited on. It was purchased specifically for video editing. So to give you a bit of background about why this computer in the first place, basically when I was editing for my professional work, I was realizing that on Premiere Pro, I was experiencing serious performance issues and it was really, really hindering my workflow. I would be staring at render screens for sort of 30, 45 minutes out of the day. And when you're working in sort of a full-time 8-hour-a-day work, trying to get as much editing done as possible, that is a serious amount of time. So I made the decision that we should probably bump up the machine that I was editing on. I moved from, I believe, a 2016 MacBook Pro to the new 2018 MacBook Pro, and I spec'd it out. So this is kind of a 15-inch, 16 gigs of RAM, a pretty powerful machine. And I thought that all of my issues would probably be solved. To my surprise though, when I loaded up this machine and put Premiere Pro on it and got it all kind of up to speed, there wasn't really that much of a gap in performance improvement from my older 2016 MacBook Pro to this 2018 version. And just for warning, in this video, I will be talking about Premiere Pro in comparison to Final Cut Pro on the Mac ecosystem, because it's kind of pivotal to this topic. If you are video editing on Premiere Pro on Mac, I've just found the performance issues to be not really related to the hardware that you're editing on. I was editing 4K timelines and just seeing serious slow playback. I wasn't able to watch my projects back in real time at 4K. And for someone who edits videos professionally as my job, that was just a real, real issue. And I thought that making this bump to this machine with these specs would seriously improve that. Turns out, not so much. So I think that kind of brings me to my first main point. And that is that if you edit on Premiere Pro, Adobe Premiere, predominantly, or by extension, After Effects, this machine is not going to be your fix. It is not going to drastically improve performance to the point where you can just edit videos completely flawlessly, like I thought it might be my experience. I do just want to stress that if you are having real performance issues with Premiere Pro on Mac, I cannot suggest enough that you try out Final Cut Pro 10. Kind of shortly after buying this machine, I did a bunch of research and pretty much found out that Final Cut is so much better hardware optimized for the Mac ecosystem and the Mac products that you are buying, that it just is a performance night and day compared to Adobe on these platforms. What that means is the serious bump in specs as an upgrade in buying this machine had a real kind of not a massive significance in terms of performance bump on Premiere Pro. The biggest bump in efficiency within my editing workflow has been that switch from Premiere Pro to Final Cut 10 that I did at the beginning of the year. So I now edit on this machine for my professional work, and then I have my own, I believe, a 2016 MacBook Pro in space gray that they came out with a few years ago, and I also edit on Final Cut Pro with that. And there is a performance gap here. The newer 2018 spec'd out MacBook Pro is a lot smoother to edit on Final Cut than on my own personal 2016 model. That is not to say that performance is bad. It is night and day difference from the experience I was having on my older 2016 MacBook using Premiere, then switching over to Final Cut. I can now edit in 1080p and have pretty much flawless timeline playback with no issues and render videos out at a decent pace. But the 2018 MacBook Pro is a significant bump in performance over that. Editing 4K videos in Final Cut is an absolute breeze, but I mentioned on Premiere, I was still experiencing issues with that 2018 model. Now we get to one of the biggest complaints with this machine that is all over the internet when it came out. You would have definitely heard about it if you've been looking into this model of machine, and that is overheating. So this MacBook does get hot, and again, it sounds like I'm just massively biased, but I'd want to reiterate that on Premiere, this machine was getting hot, really overheated, really not a great editing experience experience at all. The Switch to Final Cut did help that, I guess, because it's just much more optimized for the Intel CPUs within this machine. The patches that Apple has put in place since its release have definitely improved the heating issues. The machine does get hot, it does get warm, but it's happening less and less frequently. So if you're editing on Premiere, maybe one to think about, but if you're editing on any other software, I wouldn't be too worried about the heating problem on this 2018 MacBook Pro. So all in all, in summary guys, I just kind of feel like there are better ways to spend your dollars. This machine is an absolute powerhouse on the Mac ecosystem, but I do feel like if you're editing on Premiere, there are far better ways to spend your dollars. Maybe try out Final Cut like I've suggested. If you do want to watch a video on my direct comparison, link to that down below in the description below the like button. If you're buying a MacBook for the first time, of course you may want to check out this 2018 model, or maybe wait to see what Apple releases in its 2019 versions. In my opinion, for video editors, there are better choices. Hopefully you guys have found that video useful if you were looking at picking up a 2018 MacBook Pro model. Please let me know if you have any comments, questions, suggestions. Drop a comment down below and I'll be responding as ever. And I'll catch you guys next time.